Hello everyone, it's Axel from SEGGER. Today I want to talk about the Rotary object in AppWizard. So with the Rotary object, you can make some really, really nice analog dials. For example, like this one. Or you can actually also use it to make some pretty nice custom gauges, as you can see over here. So if you want to add a rotary object in your own GUI, you'll find it over here along with all the other objects. So you click on it and it will be added to your GUI. You can see it and place it wherever you need the rotary to go. And by default, this is the kind of rotary you get. It's just a placeholder design and it just spins freely. And you can now go ahead and customize this in the properties that you see over here, including the ID, the position, the anchor point, but most importantly, the bitmaps. So if we want this rotary to look different, we can change the background. So for example, we can give it a different look, for example, this one, and place it properly. Then we also want to give it a different marker. Let's use this one. And we then need to make some adjustment to the radius. Let's put that to 100, and that looks better. So to see what kind of values we're getting from our rotary, the first thing I want to do is use an interaction to, whenever the rotary value changes, I want to output the value to a text box that I already have in decimal mode. And if I hit the play mode, which is our handy feature to always see what our GUI is doing, I can see it's turning freely and it's giving me a variety of values based on tenths of degree. Now, let's say I want to have a 0 value here and I want a 100 value over here. So in order to achieve that, I need to adjust some more properties of our rotary. So the first thing I want to do is make sure our initial value is 0, which is the case. And then I can adjust the span of values that I need. So for example, from 0 to 100. In addition to that, so that my marker will be over here as the default, I need to set an offset. So I'll set that to 2400, and that makes sure my marker points to where I want it to point by default. So the last thing that is necessary is just to make sure that we set the right range for our rotary. So instead of 1800 plus and minus tenths of degrees, that will go to from 0 to 3000. And now when we switch to play mode, we will see that our rotary performs as we wanted it to, giving us values from 0 to 100. You will notice that when you specify both a range and a span of values, then the rotary returns the specified minimum value at the positive, meaning counterclockwise range limit, and the specified max value at the negative, meaning the clockwise range limit. Now, in addition to the text value, I can also output the values on a prog bar that I also have already on my GUI. So I can add another interaction that says when my rotary changes its value, I want to set the value to my progress bar. And let's see how that looks. So that looks good, giving me a bar graph indication from 0 to 100%. Another important property is the period here. So that controls how freely my rotary will spin. So if I put a value in here in a number of milliseconds, for example, 250, then you can see that the rotary will come to a halt much quicker. It doesn't spin as freely anymore. So you have total control over that with this parameter. Of course, you probably also want to pick up the values of your rotary in your user code. So you could add another interaction that just says when the rotary value changes, then just have a null here. So that will create just a slot in your user code that will get called whenever the value changes, and you can decide what kind of code will be executed in that case. You can enter it here in AppWizard or alternatively in your IDE in your project. But of course, there's a lot of other things you can do with your rotary. So these are the signals that the rotary can emit. And these are all the actions that you can take when that particular signal gets emitted. And you can find all these actions and jobs described in the user guide. So in a nutshell, this is what you can do with a rotary in AppWizard. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please make sure to check out our other videos on AppWizard, and thanks for watching.